have difficulty grasping the fullness of this revelation is because we much prefer the sovereign Savior over the suffering servant.
Jesus tries to cry out in his most difficult moment to God. Some of y'all don't need that. Maybe you grew up like me. You ain't seen your daddy since 3 years old. And if you haven't seen your father, or you live in a house where there's not a father for the children that are there, like 67% of the homes in the African-American community, then you know why sometimes you gotta call on God, because father, daddy, papa, mud ain't really around. Pastor, he woke you up this morning. That's a rack blessing. He started you on the way. That's a rack blessing. He put food on your table. That's a rack blessing. He put clothes on your back. That's a rack blessing. You ought to be able to give God praise for rack blessing. But can I drop something on you? Not only do we serve a God that'll give you rack blessings, but God got some custom-made blessings. Y'all looking at me like I'm crazy. God got some custom-made blessings, because there's some stuff that God has made just for you, and it ain't for nobody but you. Do I have?
What in the world are you doing with the breath that he gave you? I ain't talking about the breath that he gave Adam. No. When he came back with a whole different kind of breath. He blew on every one of them. And then he said, now you go out. Whoever you forgive, they are forgiven. Whoever you don't forgive, they're not forgiven. In other words, engage people in their lives. The bottom line is that he took my breath away and he gave it back to me for me to do something with it. Slap your neighbor, high five.
Painting that is right before your eyes. Well, what are you talking about? Simple. It's because he used the word them, and you want to know who them is. I know that you do. Them was not just simply those who were there, but them is you. Them is them. Them is us. Okay, y'all ain't really with that. Them is anybody who is contrary to the righteousness of God, which simply is the definition of sin. And so if anybody has done anything that's contrary to God's word, his will, and his way, then you are a part of sin. And so you need something to cover that sin. And if you get it covered, then you get it cleansed. And then that cleansing puts you in a right position with God. And so he says, I need you now to fulfill the work in me, so I need you to cover them. But this-